Okay, we'll continue with this one. Bar magnet, you might have come across in high school. Just do listen. Happily, you can sleep. Don't sleep. Lie down and happily listen for it. No need to put any extra effort. Just you have to keep on listening. So let's get into the bar magnet. So what is our topic? Our topic is like a magnetism and materials. Magnetism and materials. These are our name of the chapters. I think first let me write here. So that will be easy. Magnetism and materials. In that subtopic is first, we'll start with a bar magnet. What is the core idea? What is that magnetism? How do it will come? From where that magnetism, like we have electric field. Similarly, what is the source for magnetism? And what are the different types of magnetic materials and their application? What we studied is electromagnetism. Go back, when a current flows, electromagnet, that's what we studied. Now what happened? We are going to study the magnetism and materials. Different type, different shaped magnets, and how do they produce magnetic field. Then what is the source for magnetism and the application? Of all, we are very important. And if you see that, the earth is also will magnet. And how to study the field of a magnetic field of a earth, how to measure that. So these are the some best methods we are going to bring it. I'll start with a bar magnet. So when you take a bar magnet, it will have this is called like a North Pole. The North Pole, usually if you take the real bar magnet when you purchase it, they will indicate a dot. The dot indicates North and South. It's there in a lab manual, not covered in book, but can be asked here. So when you purchase a bar magnet, they'll indicate a dot. The dot will indicate the North Pole, and that one, the hand where there is no dot, that is a South Pole here. So look at this for dot. This is a practical way of identifying the bar magnet, the poles. So now this is the North Pole and South Pole. So this is the physical length of the bar magnet. And we do have a magnetic length. Geometrical length, physical length, that one. And this particular thing is called like a magnetic, this one called like a pole strength, symbol is small m, or m naught will write it. And it will have magnetic dipole moment. Just recollect electric dipole moment. So what is this pole strength? This magnetic charge, or it is also called as pole strength. It's an imaginary one. It's an imaginary. Imaginary since like a magnetic charge. No, we can never get isolated magnetic charge. We are just making ourselves, we are creating that it's isolated one. So if say, what are the magnetic charges? There are two types of charges, or magnetic charges. One, North Pole. So this will become positive magnetic charge. Next, again, we have South Pole, this will be negative. Since we have background of electrostatics, no, we are trying to learn everything through comparing with electrostatics. Like how we had positive charge, negative charge. Similarly, the North Pole is called like a positive charge, positive magnetic charge, and the South Pole is called as negative magnetic charge. The same pole strength only it is called as. And then magnetic dipole moment, capital M. Now what is the symbol for this? M naught will put it. In books they're given small m, or some books they're given P. This magnetic dipole moment. So what is the magnetic dipole moment? It is equal to magnetic length into pole strength. So we know what is the unit for magnetic dipole moment, ampere, meter square, length is meter. So what can be unit for pole strength? Will be ampere meter. is a unit for pole strength here. And how that magnetic dipole moment and pole strength are related? The separation between the pole strength, the poles, and the into product into the magnetic pole strength. So that will become the magnetic dipole. When you purchase a bar magnet, the very first question they'll ask you, what type of bar magnet you want? We have now different types of bar magnet. You do one thing, you go to any bookshop nowadays, around 20 rupees, you get different shape bar magnets. Like you get a bar magnet, Osho magnet, you get a circular disc magnet, a ring magnet. Different. So different bar magnets are there. What about the dipole moment? The dipole moment is given by this condition. Like a magnetic length into pole strength. So what is LM? Magnetic length here. So what is a basically pole strength? It's like a magnetic charge here. So now we'll go for definition. So what is a pole strength? It can be the strength of a magnetic pole to attract magnetic materials. Towards itself. Means you take any magnetic material, the North Pole open will attack, the South Pole open will ripple. There's a generalized way of this one. And now, what that magnetic pole or the magnetic charge, it will produce field around it. I think let's not go to electrostatics because we never get isolated magnetic pole. So let's not go back. Some books they're called applying Coulomb's law, everything they brought. Okay, let's try to avoid that one. Let's not make it total similar to electrostatics. This will have some idea of that one. I'm trying to skip that particular method. Some books they're given like that also. If you look at even SURM also, he has talked everything about magnetic charge only. Nothing wrong. Now, what is the pole strength? So some books they're given round symbol, anything. So it doesn't matter. So it will produce field, magnetic field, radially outward. As it is a North Pole. So what is the North Pole? North Pole will produce field radially outward. M naught. So this M naught, I'll replace with North Pole. What about South Pole? Which will produce radial inward field. Isolated point magnetic charge. It's imaginary, hypothetical. But it will really help us a lot to get into the concept. What is a magnetic charge? How much magnitude? M naught. Like how we have a charge Q naught. Like that here, the magnetic charge is M naught here. And two types of charges, positive, negative. Positive charge is called a North Pole. Positive magnitude charge is North Pole. Negative magnetic charge is called as a South Pole here. So like this, whatever, and we can assume a field like this, of this kind. This particular magnetic charge, if it is kept in a magnetic field, will it experience any force? Yes, very much. Suppose say there is a uniform magnetic field is there. There's a uniform magnetic field. If a positive North Pole, I'll write it straight away. In what direction will experience a force? In this direction. What about the South Pole? If the South Pole is there, it will expend force opposite to direction of magnetic field. Now straight away, let me get the bar magnet. I think bar magnet is having two poles, one North Pole and South Pole. Now in what direction the now there's a direction of field, B bar. In what direction this will expend force in this direction. This will expend force in this direction. Now, if the bar magnet is kept at an angle, No. Okay, there's a North Pole. This is the South Pole. Again, the force will be, this is Fn, this will be Fs. Similar to electric dipole idea, and how the dipole moment of the bar magnet will be directed from south to north. What is this M bar? The magnetic dipole moment. It'll be always directed from south to north, like similarly in electric dipole. See, first we had idea of magnetism, then that ideas are introduced to electrostatics. We are coming reverse way. First we are studying electrostatics, then we are coming here. First we had a practically, if you look at the history, no, we had a better idea of the magnetic field, all particular thing, magnetic dipole moment. Then what happened? Later what happened? We started searching for anything like that, electric dipole moment, polarization, everything. Since we studied electrostatics, so therefore I'm comparing with electrostatics. But books what happened? Electrostatics is compared with magnetism because we had better information of magnetism than electrostatics. Okay, don't blame me. I'm teaching in wrong way. Okay, this is about a bar magnet kept in a magnetic field. Will it experience a force? Yes, it all depends on orientation. Will I agree? Sir, what about that force you are saying? How to calculate that force? So what is Fn is equal to? Fn equal to pole strength into the magnetic field, Q into E. Similarly, what is Fs? Fs should be equal to pole strength into magnetic field. Q into E bar, Q E bar. Similar, the same method here. Pole strength into magnetic field. Magnetic charge into magnetic field will give the force acting on the North Pole. Agree this again. Don't get into like this. Sorry, if I project a South Pole, you can't do that isolated. I'll write somewhere in the corner. Isolated magnetic charge is not possible practically. This is just only on paper, huh? Or unipole, magnetic, like a unipole, not possible. Okay, this is about the basic information. Let's get into that pole strength. So here, how, like a magnet, so definitely open, I'll go for very, so like a powerful magnets. So when the magnet will be very powerful, it's having a very good dipole moment. Magnetic dipole moment of bar magnet is something very important. When you go and purchase any bar magnet, the very first question that they will ask you, what is the dipole momentum of you want? Definitely say that I want powerful magnet. Then you'll give the bar magnet which is having M very high value. So how to like a have good value of I value of capital M dipole moment? The pole strength should be more. The pole strength should be more, that one. Okay, now again we have two lengths here, one geometric length, or you can say physical length, and there is magnetic length. You see, the poles will not be exactly at the ends, they'll be slightly inside the magnet. And if you see the ratio, the magnetic length, which will be 5/6 times of geometric length. Slightly, what happened? The poles, what happened, will be slightly inside what? Like inside the, well, slightly inside the magnet here. Means if you take a magnet, you don't get North Pole here. The North Pole will be slightly inside here, South Pole will be here. And when you measure the physical length, will be greater than the magnetic length here. We can never measure what? We can never measure the joy, you can say like the magnetic length here. So what we can measure is only the physical length. From physical length, I'll calculate the magnetic length, and I'll calculate the pole strength. From that, I'll calculate the dipole moment. This is the methodology. I'm making things clear. We can never measure this magnetic length. But sir, how do? There's a theoretically it was designed by using all experiment. Finally, they came to conclusion this much here. So what we can measure very easily means exactly we can measure the geometric physical length or geometrical length. And if you know geometrical length, you can get the magnetic length. If you know magnetic length and pole strength, I can measure. So I'll get the magnetic dipole moment. Fine. So there's one formula which you should remember. Okay, next after this, if you take the bar magnet, no, these this there's a bar magnet, it's having a pole strength. M naught, this one. Then dipole and length, let it be. Now there are two axes, I'm going to define it. This is called as equatorial line. This is called as axial line. Okay, fine. So these are things, or bisector. Or broadside end-on position, because there's a broadside. No, if you take bar magnet, there's a broadside, there's a narrow side. This is called like a broadside end-on position. I think in SUMI you have to use a terminology like this, where the magnet field on the broadside end-on position. So it's talking about this particular thing. Broadside end-on position means here, like, you know, on axial line. This is called like axial line. So like this. No, there's a bar magnet here. So now. So what is the physical? What is the geometrical length? So like, what is the magnetic length? Will be 12. So what is the dipole moment of this bar magnet? M into 2L into M naught. I would have written only L, but let me say that from equatorial line, the pole strength will be at a distance, equidistance, L, let it be at a distance L. So what is the dipole moment equal to 2L into M naught? Now I'm going to cut this bar magnet. Let me cut that into two parts. I'll break up this into two equal parts. So I'll break up in this way. What will happen to pole strength? Pole strength will not change. Let me write here on the inside. And the magnetic length has changed. So what happens to the new dipole moment? M dash we'll call it. So earlier what is M? Capital M, 2L M naught. Now what is M dash? M dash is equal to L M naught. So what happened to dipole moment? When you cut, how we are cutting? We are cutting normal to axial line. I'll cut the bar magnet into two equal parts. Normal to axial line. Then I'll get two bar magnets. Then this will become south pole again. Again, don't think that south. This will be north. This will be south. This will be north. So dipole moment will become off. Now I can also cut this in. I'll cut this into two equal parts. Now, what happened to the geometric length? What happened to the magnetic? Magnetic length has remained, and the pole strength is going to decrease. It'll become off. So M naught by 2. M naught by 2. M naught by 2, M naught by 2, and this is 2L. So this is M dash, this is M dash. So I'm going to divide the pole strength, no? The mag charge is getting divided. So what is m dash? In this case will be 2L m naught by 2 will be L m naught. I can cut this into n number of pieces. Not in this, I can cut this into n number of pieces. So like this now, we'll take the bar magnet. If I cut that into n number of pieces, what conditions will come? So I can cut it in many according to my requirement, that one. So if I cut that into n number of pieces, there's a bar magnet. So I'm going to cut this into n number of pieces here, so that n number of pieces will come here. Now what is the m dash? Dipole momentum of individual bar magnet will come like this. What happened to pole strength? I think inside you have to, I don't have space, so I'll just show two lines. Is it enough? The pole strength will not change, no? When you cut parallel to the bisector. What are two black lines? They are the pole strength. It will be south and north pole, that one. So what has decreased? The magnetic length has decreased. I'll cut that into n number of pieces here, n parts. What these, all these are? And tell me what I should do, what I shall write m dash of individual bar magnet. So what are these dots? Two parallel lines, they are the pole strength. Pole strength is not going to change. For only one, I'll show it, m naught. I'll cut that into n parts, parallel to the or perpendicular to axial line. Then what is m dash? M dash will become equal to, first we'll write m. What is capital M? Capital M is equal to 2L into M naught. What is the length of each small n parts? I cut it. So therefore, M dash should be equal to, pole strength will be as it is, no? So what happened? The magnetic length? The magnetic length got decreased. So 2L by N. So 2L M naught is what? M. So if you cut a bar magnet perpendicular to axial line, into n parts, then the dipole momentum of each part will be m by n. Now we can also cut along the axial line. I think, okay, let me show it here. The length has not changed. Pole strength is going to change, no? When this bar magnet cut it. So a part of pole strength will come here, a part of pole strength will come here. So now when you cut it along axial line, if you cut it equatorial line, pole strength will not change. Magnetic length will change. If you cut it along axial line, then what happened? The pole strength is going to change here. The magnetic length will remain as it is. Now, what is this M dash? Later on, afterwards, I'll color it, then I'll post it. So portion has decreased by, so it is divided into, say, n parts. So what is m dash? M dash should be equal to magnetic length is 2L. Then pole strength, how much it got reduced? M naught by N. So M dash equal to M by N. That is N P. So we'll do one thing. I'll change symbol. We'll use P something. It'll be better. Let this be Q. P parts. Okay, Q parts like that. So fine. So now after this, so let me take a bar magnet. So this having a dipole moment M, I'm going to take a part like this. So let this be the some part. I'll take it. And now how to, what is this? This will be like this. P parts you can divide. I think we took that as Q, no?
Yeah.
And what is the dipole momentum of this one? This shaded one. Total dipole momentum of bar magnet is M. The dipole momentum of this, let me shade it here. This M dash is what needed. Like that, if you cut this into P parts, then you are going to cut this into Q parts here. So what can be M dash? So shall we put M dash is equal to M by PQ? Q parts, P parts. Okay, fine. Sir, why we are doing S? In fact, in some of the applications where if the bar magnet is taken into 3/4 path, 1/4 path, no? So we should know, we should be in a better position to calculate the dipole momentum of the remaining part. That's what the type of questions what you can encounter in exam. So they may ask you questions like this. If there's a bar magnet, this length is say A, this is B, pole strength they'll give value M naught. What is the dipole momentum of 1/4 of the part? What is this? This will become 1/4 of that one. 1/4 means how much it will become? B by 2. This will become A by 2. Then dipole moment of this, how much will become? M naught by 2. What is the, this is M, this M dash. So what is M dash? M dash should be equal to, what is the length? Length will become A by 2. This is M naught by 2. So this will become A M naught by 4. And what is A M naught? A M naught should be the dipole moment. Numericals, a bar magnet, 1/4 of it is taken and suspended. So how to calculate the dipole moment of that 1/4? There's a method. So you be careful. Very simple and very important in this one. The information will be so simple for you that when in exam, such small things may trouble you if you're not alert. Okay, this is about the basic idea of the dipole moment. So it is similar to how it will be directed always from south to north pole. So this is the south pole, this is the north pole. And now this pole strength depends on what? And this is one very good question. Some CBSE book is what he has gone to some extent here, like he's telling on what factor the pole strength depends. Pole strength is telling. That means now some student there asked like, sir, I'll remove this pole strength here. You are saying something pole, you know, I'll remove this. I'll remove these two poles. Then there won't be magnetism, not like that. There's a representation. So if you remove this particular thing, so like you just erase, then no magnetism, no, not like that. This bar magnet, overall it's magnetism. No, we do represent by this particular pole strength. The idea of pole strength is very important for it, or the magnet dipole moment. Now the pole strength of a magnet so depends on cross section nature and state of magnetization. It's cross section, it's different, like a broad magnet, narrow magnet, cross section, nature and state of nature means is it made up of nickel, iron, cobalt or any other diamagnetic, paramagnetic substance. Then state of magnet, how much it got magnetized. Iron is not a magnet, but you can magnetize it. How much you magnetize it, that will all determine the pole strength here. So there's a one, in magnetic materials, you'll understand that magnetization means what, like nature and magnetization. Here, I think at least you are able to see the cross section of bar magnet that will determine the pole strength here. It's not saying the geometric length, you can see. I don't think so, geometric length will have any influence. But when you cut this into two parts, you can see pole strength will decrease by half. So therefore, I'm bringing cross section. And the pole strength depends on these parameters here. Okay, this is the one small generalized idea regarding the bar magnet. How do the field due to bar magnet? The next part. The magnetic field due to bar magnet. We'll stick onto the same thing. This is the axial line. This is a reference axial line. And this is an equatorial line. And this is for our reference we are drawing. The bar magnet will not produce these dotted lines. It's a three-dimensional, I'm showing only the plane diagram. It's a three-dimensional no two lines should intersect. There's also one has to take care. There's a direction of the magnetic field. There's a north pole and south pole. Inside the bar magnet, the lines of force will be from south to north. External to magnet, the lines of force will be from north to south. It all depends on the magnet, how many lines I'm going to draw it. This is a bar magnet. This rectangular block is a bar magnet. I know if you draw a tangent at any point, you want the magnetic field. You draw a tangent, the tangent will give the direction of B bar at that particular thing. So on the axial line, how the B bar on the axial line, the B bar will be along M bar. Always show that M bar. On the how the B bar will be on the axial line, it will be in the direction of M bar. Similar to electric dipole, just correlate, it will be on safer side. Then here it will be opposite to M bar on the axial, on the equatorial line. Of course, the magnitude will be different. I'm just showing only the direction of this one. So anywhere if you want here, B bar here, you draw a tangent. This will give the direction of B bar. So you want at this particular point, draw a tangent and give the direction of B bar. So this is called as axial line. This equatorial line. In SUMO, what is calling this called a broadside on position, hand on position, hand, because this is the end of the magnetism, hand on position. Broadside on portion. This is a broader side, no? Broadside on portion. That equatorial line or broadside on portion, axial line and on portion. Both things are being defined in NCERT. If you look at the CBSE textbooks, no? In exams, find the magnetic field on the end on position. Means he's asking somewhere, at additions are. Means he's asking here on axial line. So the terminology here is end on position, it is called as. Equatorial line or broadside on position. NCERT book used equatorial axial line. S.C. Verma used broadside on position, end on position. Both are justified in exams. Either of words can be asked. So get familiar with both the things. So how the lines of force, and they are like a not like a electric lines of force. They'll originate at north, positive charge, terminate at like a negative charge. But here what happened? They don't have anything called like a origination and termination. So they are continuous. So therefore, B bar dot ds will be zero, no? Integral of. This is what I think the Gauss law for magnetism. So magnetic lines of force, what shall we call it? Say continuous. They're always in a closed path. They don't have any origination or termination point here. Whereas electric lines of force are discontinuous. So in or we can also put in form of sentence. Magnetic lines of force are continuous. So just get this information. Now, what we are interested, we are definitely very much interested to know the field due to surrounding bar magnet. Means at several points, how to calculate the field. So can we go back to the electrostatics? Yes, we have brought some several methods. So same thing, I'll continue. So now, B bar of short bar magnet. Okay, time being, let me write it. In the end, we'll go for, okay, draw the diagram. So this is our diagram. Just I'll put a dot, huh? That'll be sufficient. Now here to calculate the magnetic field on the axial line. But how to bring that one? So as I said, it's a magnetic charge. So you can take help of that particular condition. And there's a dipole moment, there's a length, let it be. This length is L. The dipole pole strength is M naught. And it is having a dipole moment, M bar. So what is M bar is equal to? 2L M naught. So I want at point P1, which is at a distance X. I want the magnetic field due to this bar magnet. Okay, now work out, I'll have water. No, I think we'll go back to a little bit Coulomb's law. Like if you have a magnetic charge, suppose say there's a north pole. Pole strength is M naught. What is the magnetic field at a distance R? Is given by formula mu naught M naught 4 pi R square. KQ by R square, how we write now, similarly. Mu naught M naught. What is M naught? M naught is what? That magnetic charge. M naught is what you can call that as a magnetic charge here. So there's a one formula, you know, and as there's a north pole, as it is a north pole, positive magnetic charge, no? So therefore the field will be away. So this is BN, you write it. If it were south pole, the field would have been towards that magnetic charge. And there's a very generalized approach is what we can have that one. Similar to Coulomb's law. Similar to Coulomb's law here. So what is the field strength at point P1? Due to north pole, it will be like this. Due to south pole, the field will be this direction. What is the resultant field? The resultant field is given by BP1 equal to BN minus BS. So mu naught M naught 4 pi at what distance it is x minus L O square mu naught M naught. Then sign already I given in the diagram. Don't again put M naught negative sign, sir, negative charge. Already the sign is taken care by assuming the direction. Then I'm taking the difference here. Or you put here positive, then you have to substitute a negative sign, then become negative here. So this will become 4 pi. M naught 4 pi. This will be 4XL or one step I'll write it. No, simplification of this will be resultant field B bar is equal to mu naught M naught 4 pi. This will be 2XL minus of 2XL. This will be X square minus L square whole square. Four XL by this will be 4 pi. X square minus L square that one. So let me bring the dipole, because what we know of bar magnet, only dipole moment. So that 2L x naught, I'll adjust for that. So this will be what will be left over. 2 mu naught 4 pi x square L square all to the power of 4. This will be m naught. In that, what happened? M naught into 2L will become the dipole moment, m. And now we have this much here. This is for bar magnet. Usually what all we do problems is for short bar magnet. What is a short bar magnet? This length will be very small compared to x. So for short bar magnets, so what is the condition now? L will be very much less than x here. One x will be here present. Then what is the resultant formula will be? 2 mu naught m naught by 4 pi x cube it will come. So this is the dipole moment for a short bar magnet. All our numericals will be for short bar magnet only. I'm making things clear. On the axial line, it is. There's a field. So you try to show at this particular point how the field. Field will be in this direction, in the direction of M bar. On the axial line or end on position, the magnetic field will be in the direction of axial line. Okay, now similarly, I want on equatorial line. I think the N formula must compulsory, everyone must know it. We'll go for B bar. B bar on equatorial line of a bar magnet. This is the North Pole. So at a distance y, so let this be length be L, this is L, dipole momentum of this be M, and the pole strength M naught and M naught. Now I want at point P2, what is the magnetic field strength? Okay, let's get into, no, this one. Due to positive charge, the field should be away. And due to negative charge, the field should be directed towards the negative charge. So this will be due to BN, due to BS. So let this angle be theta. This angle be theta. So the resultant field, how it will be? It will be directed along negative x-axis or opposite to M bar, the resultant field. So the resultant field is given by BP2. And we know magnetic field, BN and BS, how much it is? So let this be Y, let this be R. That should be equal to mu naught, M naught, 4 pi R square. Okay, the resultant field BP2 is equal to 2BN cos theta. What is cos theta? I think L by R. So mu naught 2L M naught. Let me arrange things. So 4 pi R cube. So 2L M naught is what? Dipole moment. So this will become mu naught M by 4 pi R cube. Or if I substitute further, or so let it be this one. So what is R? R will be y square plus l square to the power of 3 by 2. This is the thing. So for a short bar magnet, y will be greater than l. For short bar magnet, L will be very much less than Y, or Y will be greater than L. So then the magnetic field will become mu naught M by 4 pi Y cube. So I think it's quite very simple, no? Two times. So what you calculate field at a distance, say like a R, or say like a distance S here, and also this, say let it be at a distance 1 meter. I'll calculate field. Again, on the equatorial line, 1 meter. The field here will be twice of this particular field. At all points on equatorial line, how the B bar will be opposite to M bar. At all points on axial line, the B bar will be in the direction of M bar. So like this, what happened? We'll get a basic necessity condition. Okay, agree now? This one. So the formulas you do remember now. Okay, now can we find out field anywhere? How to calculate field anywhere? Again, you have to get into the mathematics. So instead, this what happened? Already we know some electric dipole, if you remember. Those ideas, I'll bring it so that I'll find out the field anywhere. So if you look at the JE mains, I think 1 year he has asked the field here, but in NCERT or SMR, nowhere we have any discussion on them. He is asking somewhere field a random point here. For that, what you should do? I think in exam you can't manage. Means the field due to this, due to north pole, due to south pole, then vectors, cosine rule you have to apply. Not possible. So therefore, better let's have one formula. So that will be on safer side, because books they have discussed only on axial line and equatorial line. But in exam they have asked mains. Somewhere here also. But NCERT book, nothing, no description of that other than axial equatorial line. So you can't just read alone NCERT book and say that, sir, I read NCERT book. Okay, fine, sir. So this is what happens. Once your JE mains exams approaches, no? Administrators will come and tell that, read NCERT book, because if you read NCERT book, then JE mains you can master it. That may happen in other subject, not in physics. You look at the JE mains. Of course, we follow NCERT book, but NCERT book alone will not help us. You look at the questions, around 40% of questions which are not related to NCERT means application oriented, which are not being described in NCERT. Toppling, you see how much they describe in NCERT, one paragraph. But I can ask you any question of toppling, no? So physics, what happened? Try to see that. Because what will happen? See, you are in a big mess. Once exam comes, no, suddenly an administrator will come read NCERT book. Then what happens? You start reading NCERT. Very first time when you start reading NCERT book, it's very difficult for you to follow that language. And you'll waste your resources in what? Trying to understand what he's saying. And already teacher has discussed everything. So last moment reading NCERT, try to avoid. If you're reading now, okay, problem. Make practice of reading now only, but not last moment. But if you just read NCERT book, then you'll get a better rank. Not possible. You look at all CBSE students. Over the whole 2 years, every day they read. So I think if you go for Kendriya Vidyalaya, some CBSE schools are there, no? That one. Every day what happened? They'll read NCERT book. What about the rank? Sufficient rank is not coming. No? The reason? See, reading theory and solving numerical are two different aspects of students. Are two different aspects. That one. So if you do one, the other one will come, nothing like that. So just mere reading NCERT again will not help you. You have to read theory, then again you have to practice numericals. I'm making clear. Last moment reading NCERT you have to avoid. So shall I say goodbye to NCERT? As a teacher, what you can say? Yes, you can do that. Sir, I have integrated book, I'll read that only. Yes, carry on. But carry on only that. If you want, you can do numericals in NCERT. Solved example, that one. But last minute reading NCERT or to avoid. So there's the one plan I'm telling you. So don't get deviated. There's a biggest problem, because once exams come, no, your approach will change. You'll be under pressure. Some XYZ will tell something and you'll try to follow it. But nothing to do that one. Okay, let's go for some any arbitrary point how to calculate. I'll bring the idea of the electric dipole because that's the only thing what we know it, no? This not needed. One small magnetic potential, I'll bring it. I just should say I'm just deviating off the topic so that I can generate a formula. The derivation not being stressed in the book. Okay, no problem. We'll have for our convenient. This one. So I want exactly somewhere here. So at this particular point P is what I want the magnetic field. So what information we know? So it will make an angle theta with dipole moment, and the dipole moment vector is this one. Because that is the only thing what we'll be knowing, and this we know, this is a south pole, this is a north pole. Okay, let it be at a distance r. So what info practically what we'll be knowing? We'll be knowing r and theta. R, theta and m. We'll not be knowing even the pole strength also. So I can't, or else if you want, you can go for it. If you are very good in mass, no. So you assume one, say like a, due to this, so roughly, or we'll take it like this. Huh? You assume this. No, at this particular point, what you should do? What you should do? Due to this positive charge, Bn will be like this. Due to negative charge, Bs will be that. The resultant of that, what happened, will give Bp. The field, the magnitude and direction. And it will be mathematical, will be very difficult. So let's, instead that, let me go for an alternative. I'll define magnetic potential. As magnetic field is a conservative field. So the magnetic potential is given by mu naught 4 pi m cos theta r square. What is m? Dipole moment due to bar magnet. As it is a conservative field, we can define magnetic field here. So then it will have two components. One, B parallel. Another is B perpendicular. The B parallel is given by minus dv by dr. I'll differentiate this. So this will become how much is equal to 3 mu naught, or it's like a 2 mu naught m cos theta 4 pi r cube. Shall I write directly differentiating this equation with respect to r? I'll get the parallel component. What is parallel component? Parallel to r, because see this position vector is something very important. So what is b parallel? One which will be along r bar, position vector. What is r bar? Position vector. Then b perpendicular is given by minus 1 by r dv by dt. Differentiating this with respect to four pi r square. So this will become how much is equal to and this two will not come, no? Yeah. So this should be, everything will become mu naught m sine theta 4 pi r cube. If you are very intelligent, go back to electric dipole where p is there, replace m, problem over. No need to bother much. That's why what you study, both, it's going to help you a lot. So what is the resultant magnetic field? The vector sum of these two. So how that b bar, the resultant field will be somewhere like this. And this B bar will make some angle. What? With B parallel, with position vector. So I want the net field at point P. BP should be equal to B perpendicular square, B parallel square. Mu naught 4 pi r square m. R cube, it will be there. So say I'll just what all I know, electric dipole moment, that thing I'm applying. There it was P, here it is M. Why 3 has come? Because if you square it, 4 will come, no? So 4 cos square theta plus sin square theta. 1 cos square theta, sin square theta will become 1. So 3 cos square theta will be left over. So there's a magnitude. What about the direction? I think we should know how to define the direction suitably. So the direction is what, the tan phi. So how to define tan phi? Tan phi should be equal to B perpendicular by B parallel. So this should be equal to how much? Tan theta by 2. So what all information will be, I know. So theta will be given for us. Yes, we know theta. Then what is the angle made by B bar with position vector? Yes, we are able to calculate, no? Here. And what about magnitude? Yes, we'll be knowing theta and R. Theta, and what is theta? Angle made by R bar with M bar. So you can cross check. Let on the axial line. On the axial line, what is theta? Will it be 0? Then what is the dipole moment? Cos 0 will be 1. So 4, 2 mu naught m 4 pi r square. Then what is the magnetic field on the equatorial line? Here on the equatorial line, theta will be 90 on equatorial line. Substitute 90, mu naught m by 4 pi r cube. That too for short bar magnet, what all we discuss. I think this is going to help you a lot, no? Like whatever, wherever let him ask, you can manage here. So roughly now, so we know the B bar here on axial line in the direction of M bar, on the equatorial and opposite M bar. What about here, anywhere orbit in this region? Yes, we can use this generalized method. Or else what you should do, due to North Pole, calculate BN, due to South Pole, BS, then take vector addition, solve it, and you'll end up this one. So there'll be more lengthier. Instead, let me go for some electric dipole moment, what all we studied, you know. I'll correlate with that. I'm bringing this formula. Now, is there any possibility where the B bar will be perpendicular to M bar? So there's a condition which will help you a lot for exam. So now let's take the condition. You have to determine, is there any possibility, first of all, where the B bar will be perpendicular to M bar? So I'm asking, so B bar should be perpendicular to M bar. So it should be like this. So let me go for the position vector, drawing like this. So this is theta. Shall I show? Yeah, this is theta. And this, if I extend it, it will come further here like this, no? Let me redraw it. This is B bar. This is the angle phi, no? Here. Because B bar should be perpendicular to M bar, that one. So here what I assumed it. Now theta plus phi is 90. I want that theta. So I'll use this formula. We know tan phi equal to tan theta all divided by 2. So what is tan phi? 90 minus theta. So tan of 90 minus theta will be cot theta. So therefore tan square theta equal to, or theta equal to tan inverse of root 2. How many points like that? Only one or several points you'll get it? Only one point or several points? I think 4 points will come, no? One more year. One more year, one more year. So surrounding bar magnet. So we will get many points where B bar will be parallel to M bar. See, I think this is what troubles for you. Huh? several points means I'll put here. I can go for n number of points, no? And there are several points on equatorial line where b bar will be opposite to m bar. And how many points I'll get where b bar will be perpendicular to m bar is one. So what about here? Here I think the theta plus phi should be 90. So one in first coordinate, second coordinate, third coordinate, fourth coordinate. So 4 points. Only four or more than here again n, here n, here n. So 4n, anything like that. I think you know enough trigonometry. Dipole moment, electric dipole moment, or sir, bar magnet, I'm not very good. Okay, take electric dipole moment and analyze. Theta plus phi should be 90 degrees. So can we assume any arbitrary angle like this where theta dash, this is phi dash. The sum of those two angles should be 90 degrees, no? That's a basic condition. So, but we have one unique value here, no? Am I right? When theta makes tan inverse of root 2 is what we'll get. So we'll get only 4 points surrounding bar magnet. Please do think numericals, like try to analyze such things. Huh? They will help you a lot in exam. Okay, after this, now we'll take the some bar mag two bar magnets are there. How to find out the field anywhere? Now there's a one bar magnet. Which is having dipole moment, and there's another bar magnet which is having dipole moment. Now let this distance be 2d and this is d. So I want at origin. So look at the orientation of bar magnets. They are oriented in this way. You have to calculate the field at origin. So where is the origin now? It lies on the equatorial line. As it lies on the equatorial line, so first we'll call this as bar magnet one. This is two. So the resultant field BO should be equal to due to first bar magnet should be opposite to that. So minus of mu naught m by 4 pi d square. Due to second bar magnet, it should be opposite to that mu naught 2m 4 pi d square. If take subtract here, mu naught m by 4 pi d square. So what is the direction of this? It will be towards right. I can keep the orientation of bar magnets in any way. So more than one bar magnet will be there. They'll ask you to calculate the field at a given point, and you check this type of question. There are around, I think, more than. Okay, I think okay 2D. Yeah? Okay, this is 2d whole square. So then how much it will be? 1 by 2, 3 mu naught. Okay, then I think some calculations will come. Mu naught m by 4 pi d, I'll take outside. 1 by 2 will come. Minus 1, minus 1 by 2. Is it okay this? No? Towards left, huh? Might be towards left. I didn't check that 2D that one. Now the bar magnets can be oriented. Okay, just see once. I'll scroll down. me take another situation. Now you have to calculate the field at the origin. Direction of m bar is given. This distance is 3d. You have to calculate the net field at the origin. So call this bar magnet 1. This is 2. So due to b1, it should be towards left. Due to b2, it should be along positive y-axis. The resultant field will be given by, first we'll calculate this one. So mu naught. Where is the point? Point lies on axial line. So 2 times will come. 2 times mu naught 2m 4 pi 3d whole square. B2 should be equal to mu naught 2 times m 4 pi d whole square. At origin is asking the resultant field. And how these two are? This is along. Positive x-axis. This is along positive y-axis. So the resultant field will be b1 square plus b2 square. Any orientation, let it be. Any orientation. Just you take the b bar is a vector. So the vector sum is what you have to take. So what about pore strength? See, magnetic charge is a scalar again. Like how we have charge scalar, no? Similarly, magnetic charge or pore strength is also a scalar. Somebody is asking that pore strength is a scalar. Okay, this is some generalized different types of questions will be coming for us, and also you can I just took the 2 magnets or 3 bar magnets. They can bring 3 also, 2, 3 orientation, different orientation. And now if it's some generalized, if they ask you some arbitrary, you have to use this formula, electric dipole based formula. Here it's an arbitrary, that one. Last one more. What should be the net field at point O? So for that to happen, the net field at point O should be 0. For that, what should be the M naught? Or I'll put some M dash. Find M dash. At origin, it must be 0. Yes, given distances d and that one. So first here, there's a dipole 1, bar magnet 1. Due to that, the field will be downward. Due to this also, the field will be downward. Okay, got this. Now m dash is like this. So the field due to this will be upward. Where is this line? What is this line? This is some sort of equatorial line. On equatorial, but sir, you said y-axis equatorial. Look at the orientation of bar magnet. The m bar is along y-axis. Then x-axis will become equatorial and this will become axial line. axial line for this bar magnet will come here. This will become equatorial line. So the net field should be zero. So due to first bar magnet, it will be downward. So minus mu naught m 4 pi 2d whole cube minus mu naught 2m 4 pi d whole cube plus this will be mu naught m dash 4 pi 3d whole cube. This should be equal to zero. So mu naught 4 pi d cube you can take outside. That everything will be, so this will become eliminated. So this will become 2 cube minus 2 this is m, no? Here m will come 2m this m dash. Solve for this, we'll get the required answer. So like this, some different things, sir. Just I think you do one thing. Randomly you assume 5-6 problems on your own, different orientation. Keep it aside this topic. So anything if they ask you field due to more than one bar magnet, as desired approach I have, I can find out. If they ask you some arbitrary year, as you can manage, you have to go for that particular formula. Okay, this is about the calculation of this one. So can we replace now, suppose say 2-3 bar magnets are there, if they are tied, how to replace the, like a 2-3 bar magnets kept at a short bar magnet kept at a point. Suppose if there are two bar magnets are there. One is M1. Dipole moment these are. You can write the resultant dipole moment as M. In this case, what is M? M1 plus M2. If the bar magnets, if the dipole moments are placed like this. They can't be like this. What you should do, you should take a adhesive tape and you have to wind it, no? Am I right? I think if you take the north-north, that one they'll try to ripple. So for that purpose, okay, you should take a thread and you should bind it. If they try to ripple away, then what is the effective dipole moment? This is the formula. In this case, what is the effective dipole moment? In the direction of the greater one. Similarly, if the magnets are arranged like this, then what is the resultant dipole moment? The resultant dipole moment is given by M is equal to root of M1 square plus M2 square. And what is that angle tan theta? M1 by M2. You can replace those two bar, short bar magnet. They should be strictly, and you can, and they should be in contact. They should not be separated far away. And now if the bar magnets are oriented like this, some angle. As dipole moments are what? Vector quantities. So the resultant dipole moment is given by M1 square, M2 square, 2 M1, M2 cos theta. You can replace that with an equivalent bar magnet whose dipole moment is equal to this much here. In numerical sorting, sometimes we get a bar magnet. Rather than fighting with individually due to M1, M2, no, you can replace with one resultant and you carry on the problem further. The orientation, how that M bar should be oriented, theta, that theta is given by this one. Similarly, you should calculate that the resultant M bar will depend on M1 and M2. Somewhere it will come like this. I think you go back to the vectors idea. Then angle made by M bar with one tan phi. Use that vector addition of two vectors formula, calculate the angle made by M bar with any one vector. So I think I'll give some rough diagram. You work out later on. This is theta, no? The resultant M bar will be like this. Calculate that angle phi, tan phi. Theta is angle between this dipole moment. So these are the some generalized things can be asked for you. Replacing the bar magnets. I'll stop here only. I think chemistry class, you can go for it. Huh? Okay, thank all of you.